Hey guys, so in today's video, I'm going to be doing a test and review of a MODELONES dip kit, and this one can be found on Amazon, and it is a pretty reasonable price, so I will be showing how to create this manicure, and let's get right into the video. Here is what the package of the dip kit looks like. So it says dip powder nail kit, and then it has a picture of what all comes inside. So basically just the dip liquids and then the dip powders. And upon opening it up, I can see that there is a little instruction manual just sharing some basic information on how to apply the color as well as how to remove it. So there are also some tips and tricks just to help you figure out how to do your dip manicure. And then looking at the products, you can see here are all of the dip liquids. So there are four. There is a brush to remove any excess powder, and then there are five different dip colors, along with a nail file and cuticle pusher just for the prep. So the first dip liquid is 00, and this is the brush saver. Next is 01, and this is the dip powder base coat. Here is 03, and this is the activator. And lastly, 04, which is the dip powder top coat. And as you may have noticed, we skipped 2, and 02 is the actual powders itself. So the first one is transparent, and as you can see here, all of the powders come sealed, which is really nice so that they don't spill out. And this is just a simple clear powder. This is 005, and it's sort of a peachy, pinky coral color. And all of these powders do have a little bit of shimmer besides the clear. Here is 006, and this is again sort of a peachy pinky shade, except this one is a little bit more cool toned and darker. And here I just want to show a comparison because they did look kind of similar, but you can definitely see a difference between the two shades. Next is 007, and this is a minty green teal shade, and this is the color I used in the video. And then here is 008, which is a light pinky purpley color. And this one definitely is a little bit more cool toned and purple out of the three pinks. So like I said, there also comes a fluffy brush to remove any excess dust and powder on the nail. There is a cuticle pusher to push back your cuticles and remove all of that dead skin. And then there is a 100 and 180 nail file. So for the demo, I'm going to be using a peel-off base coat just because I won't be keeping these dip nails on for long because I have to film other videos. And I know you've probably heard me say that a couple of times now, and this is just a little trick I like to use to easily remove my dip powder manicures. So I applied a nice even thin layer of that to all of the nails and let it dry completely before moving on. And like I said, for my manicure, I'm using 007 and transparent, which is the clear and mint green shade. So now I'm going to be going in with 01, which is the dip powder base coat, and I'm going to apply that to all of my nails, and I'm covering the entire nail from cuticle to free edge with a nice even thin layer and then dipping into the clear powder. And the reason I'm going in with a layer of clear first is to build up strength and structure so we don't have too many layers of color on the nail. So I repeated this process on all of my nails by applying the base in a thin even layer and then dipping into the clear powder. And this clear powder was very finely milled, which I really like because that means it will go on nice and smooth, and it doesn't have that grainy texture which some dip powders have. And this is something I look for in dip powders, and if it has a thin, fine texture, you know it is a good dip powder. So then after letting that dry for a little bit, I'm dusting off all of the excess clear. And now I'm going in with my color layer. So I'm taking 01, which is the base again, and I'm applying a thin even layer to the entire nail and then dipping into my colored powder. And as you can see here, this color is a little bit sheer on the first layer because you can still see my nail line through the color, which isn't necessarily a problem, but I was expecting it to be a little bit more opaque. And the way to fix this is to just go in with more layers, but again, you don't want your dip nails to get super thick, so you have to find a balance between how many layers of color you should actually do. But I decided I was going to do a second layer and see how that would look, and possibly even go in with a third. So on all of my nails, I'm repeating that first layer of color by applying a thin, even layer of base and then dipping into the powder. And this color is absolutely gorgeous. I really like it. It isn't really my cup of tea for the fall season, but I think you can really get away with it any time of year, especially if you are into this color. So then after brushing off the excess powder from the first layer, I'm going to go in with a second layer. And as you can see here, it does get pretty opaque on the second coat, but it isn't as opaque as I would like, so I'm pretty sure I went in for a third coat just to really get that full opaque and even color. But again, it's totally up to personal preference whether you want to do one, two, or three coats, just depending on the look you are going for. I personally like my dip powder nails to be opaque unless it is supposed to be sheer, like a sheer pink or a clear. So I did go in for a third coat just to get that full opacity. But for now, I'm applying the base in a thin, even layer and then dipping into the powder for a second coat. So here what the nails look like after three coats, and now I'm going in with the 03, which is the activator, and this will harden up the dip nails and make them ready to file, so it is a crucial step in the dip nail process, and I applied a generous amount to all of the nails, and I let that soak into the powder for a few minutes before I moved on to filing. Then, once completely dry, I'm taking my nail file and first starting off at the free edge and fixing up my shape, and also going along the sidewalls to make sure that they are nice and smooth and the correct shape I want. And then I'm going to be going over the surface of the nail with the file and buffer as well. So after filing the free edge, I'm taking my nail buffer and buffing over the surface of all of the nails to get that smooth, even surface so there are no ridges or bumps. And if you have a good dip powder application, you won't have to do a ton of buffing over the nails. So I repeated that on every single nail and then brushed away any excess dust still remaining on the nail. And finally, I'm going in with Dip Liquid 04, which is the dip powder top coat. And I applied a thin, even layer in thin, quick strokes, making sure to avoid the skin area and keep it as neat as possible. And on this first layer of top coat, I'm not really focusing on getting it nice and perfect. I'm really mainly concentrating on just getting a thin, even layer over the entire nail. And then after I let that first coat dry for a few minutes, I'm going in with the second layer to really add that nice and glossy finish. So here are my completed dip nails using this MODELONES dip kit. I really like how these turned out and I think they look super classic and professional. And this kit was super easy to use along with having an affordable price tag. So if you are interested in checking this kit out, I will be sure to leave the link below. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a like and subscribe down below. And I will see you in the next one.